Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 16.0.2 to the public. It's available to everyone, everywhere around the world at the exact same time. If you're on iOS 16.1, you won't have an update as you're actually on a newer version and on the betas. This is available to the public. And this came in at 352.7 megabytes, and so iOS 16.0.2's release is actually fairly small, between 250 and 400 megabytes. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then we'll go down to general, then about. And as you can see, the build number is 20A380. And according to Apple, this update includes improvements and bug fixes for your iPhone. There is no modem update in this update, at least for the iPhone 14s. Now, as far as what's new, well, the first thing is something they've fixed. And what they've fixed is the camera shake in third-party apps on the iPhone 14 devices with the 14 Pro and 14 Pro Max. So if you were having that issue in Instagram, TikTok, or any other third-party apps such as Snapchat or others that use the camera, and it would just wobble when you were using the camera, that has been resolved. Not everyone experienced it, but some people did. Also, they've fixed an issue where the display may appear completely black during device setup. So maybe you're setting up your iPhone for the first time, maybe you're swapping over from a regular SIM card to an eSIM, and then it would just go to a black screen and you couldn't do anything. That has now been resolved. So that's a great thing. Also, they've resolved an issue that was bothering a lot of us on iOS 16. So we'll go into Safari, and within Safari, you can see this is Apple's website. If we press and hold, and then maybe copy and paste this little part of the text here, press copy, and then go to another app, and then paste it, many of us were getting a prompt every single time we paste that actually asked us if we want to allow it. This was okay once, but not every single time. That has been resolved in this particular update. Also, if you're someone that uses accessibility regularly, this should be a great fix for you. This is something that could be huge in that if you go to accessibility and you're using VoiceOver, VoiceOver is now working properly after you actually reboot. Prior to this update, that could be an issue for some people. So VoiceOver may have been unavailable, and that could cause a huge issue if you're using accessibility features. I'm glad to see they've actually fixed that. They've also fixed an issue where it addresses an issue with touch input on older devices. So if you have an iPhone 10, an iPhone 11, or an iPhone XR, this actually fixes the issue where you could have unresponsive touch input. So where you might have had touch lag, you touch the display, it doesn't do anything. That's now resolved with this update. So it's great to see them fix this. I'm glad to see it happen so quickly. And it was a huge pain for a lot of people. It also resolves some security updates. Now, if we go into Safari again, and then we go over to the tab where I have Apple security updates, let's refresh. It's kind of not formatting that properly, so that could be another bug. But if we scroll down here, you'll see we have iOS 16.0.2 and watchOS 9.0.1. For this update, it says this update has no published CVE entries. Now that doesn't mean they didn't fix anything, but they actually mentioned it here for iPhone 8 and later. So they've updated that. Now watchOS 9.0.1 appears to be Apple Watch Ultra only. Originally, it just said iPhone 14 models here for the update. Now they've fixed it. So I'm glad to see they've updated this. There's nothing specific they've mentioned actually for security updates, but hopefully they've fixed some things in there. As far as additional bug fixes, Apple hasn't mentioned anything. So the issue where maybe you're playing a song, let me turn this down here. If I'm playing this song, and then maybe we go to the lock screen here, and then tap on the album art, it still bounces down into the bottom. It doesn't seem like it fits properly. So hopefully they update this soon, but that could be with iOS 16.1, but we haven't seen it in the betas yet. As far as iPhone storage, if we go into general and then iPhone storage, many people have been asking about that and how much it should be using. System data seems to be pretty reasonable with these updates. So 5.93 gigabytes, this can vary greatly to a huge amount or smaller amount. The only way to get this to drop back down is to wipe everything if you're still having issues. Typically, it will clear itself up and I wouldn't worry about it, but if you're running out of storage, make sure that you actually check that, see if it has excessive system data usage, and if it does and doesn't clear on its own, you may try clearing system cache, but I really wouldn't worry about it until you're actually out of storage and can't install apps or take photos and videos. Otherwise, maybe try and plug it into a computer and iTunes and update that way with the next update. Otherwise, I really wouldn't worry about it too much. As far as overall performance, well, it seems to be nice and fast this time around. I've had no issues going into different apps. Of course, it's only been out a little time, but on the iPhone X, the same thing is true. The phone isn't getting warm. It feels nice and cool. I see no issues going into different apps. Let's go into, we'll swipe over here, go into Apple Music. It's the first time opening it on the iPhone X today. So we'll give it a moment to load over Wi-Fi, and you'll see it's loading fine. I don't see any stutters or anything like that. So generally, I wouldn't expect performance to be affected in any way. As far as benchmark scores, I did run Geekbench 5 on this device, and it's crazy how fast the iPhone 14s are, but it scored 1,878 for single core, 5,355 for multi-core. It's pretty much identical to what you would get with iOS 16.1 or 16.0. Don't really expect any differences as far as performance. Battery life will take a few days to measure, but hopefully if you were having small issues with that, maybe it was your always on display or some excessive battery usage, hopefully it's resolved with this. I know with my iPhone, I've noticed a little bit of difference, although I've been running betas and regular versions, but with iOS 16 and the always on display, I actually noticed that I get a little bit less battery life. So maybe an hour less, even though you should be getting a little bit more, based on how I use it, I noticed the same or slightly less. However, today I've used it quite a bit. You'll see I have 6 hours and 23 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 36 minutes of screen off time, but it was actually charged a little bit too in between in my car while I was driving. If we take a look at the day before, it was pretty good at 3 hours and 2 minutes with 2 hours and 47 minutes of screen off time and using 25% of the battery. I can easily get through a day with 50% left. I would expect this to fix those issues if you were having issues with that. As far as the overall graphic update to the battery icon in the upper right, that's with iOS 16.1. So if you're waiting for those changes with that update, you'll have to wait for 16.1. Otherwise, you won't see those just yet. And as far as iOS 16.1 beta 3, I would expect that as soon as next week, with probably a final release sometime in October around the expected event for the iPad. Something around that time frame, maybe the second or third week, we could see a final release with iPadOS 16 or 16.1, whatever Apple decides to call it, and macOS Ventura. So we're waiting for all of those things. At this point, I'm really glad to see this update. It's much sooner than expected. Now, of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.